Hey YouTube, what's up? It's the vacuum guy here. Today is going to be a video of my Sanitaire dragging on that little Mr. Clean bite, so I just thought that would be amusing to some of you. Because I definitely know it's amusing for me since I have ADD and a pretty short attention span, so here we go. Yeah, room's kind of messy. Got a whole bunch of crap piled on top of my power spikes. Gotta really clean that up. There's my, I think, 1980s Kmart box fan. Don't know if anybody wants me to make a video of that, but it's a really good fan. Yeah, look at how bold this ST bag is getting. It's insane. Yeah, it's absolutely insane. Fully inflated watch. And look how much it goes down. It's like... Yeah, it's insane how full that bag is getting, and it still maintains amazing airflow. It's insane. There's a new convertible back there. Yeah, it needs a new top sleeve bearing. Oh well. That motor runs insanely hot. Well, not the motor itself, but the top sleeve bearing. It's like 2 minutes of it being on and I'm vacuuming the house. It's just, it literally gets so hot to the point where I could fry some raw meat on it and have it be safe to eat. Let's just say it'd be Chef Gordon Ramsay approved meat. I couldn't resist saying that. And I also am getting something very special within the next 2 weeks, so stay tuned. I'm not saying what it's going to be about or how it's going to be done or etc. The only person that might know is Caleb Small's Vacuums. I don't think he knows yet. I mean, he might, but if you're watching this, Caleb, keep your mouth shut, please. So, yeah. That's about it. So I'm going to show you guys my sanitizer pulling around this Mr. Clean box, and these things do wonders on vacuums. It shines that thing right up. And the base is all perfectly white and shiny, minus that crack there, but that's been crazy glued. It's been holding for the past 2 years I've had this thing, so it's all good. And overall, this is a really amazing vacuum. I freaking love this thing to death, considering the fact I put over like $100 into this thing to make it what it is. And the little cord grommet down there to actually hold the cord into the base, which is working pretty well so far. So yeah, run it for you guys one last time.
The car was so hard I can't even turn the dial on that.
Yeah, and as you already know, this has a brand new Vibra-Groomer 2 with the rubber boots on the end of it. Here's the old Vibra-Groomer 2. I took the brush strips out of it. See, it's all rusted. It has the old, like, I think they're either metal or copper. I can't really tell. But it's a 31-year-old Vibra-Groomer 2. Spins freely, I guess. But this thing was actually off balance too. Like, when I put it in the machine or the base and I spun it around, I could actually see this part moving up and down significantly. So I knew this brush roll was already off balance, and I don't know, I just didn't want to take any chances with it damaging the machine, blowing through belts, etc. So went and dropped a freaking pretty penny on a brand new Vibra-Groomer 2 that has the rubber boots on the end of it to reduce brush roll to machine vibrations, and that actually does work, and it quiets down the machine quite a bit. In case running, this thing has a 6.5 amp pancake motor in it, 2-speed. I think it's normal and 6.5 high speed is 7. That's just what I'm guessing, or the other way it could be as low as 6 amps and high as 6.5 amps. But either way, it pulls the same amount of air as a 7 amp pancake motor, sounds exactly the same, runs exactly the same. It's just all around a Sanitaire motor. Despite the fact that it's 31 years old, and it was slightly rebuilt by me, so I have a feeling this thing is going to be lasting for another 10, 20 years. I already know it will. I guarantee you the vacuum's base and everything will fail before the motor even does. But I won't let that happen, because I take really good care of my vacuums, especially this one, followed by that one, because this one's my baby. And this one also has, let's see if it'll show, over 20,000 beats per minute, lifetime lubricated bulb bearing sticker still on it, and it's pretty in good condition. And there's a couple of rust spots where it's kind of worn through, like the plastic sticker on here where it's got rusted right there, there, and there. But oh well. Unplug it. Yeah, this is the aftermarket plug that I got at Ace Hardware back when I lived downstate. And yes, I did ground the motor, grounded the handle bail, so that way I'm completely protected if anything should occur, which I wish I know it won't. But just to be safe. And plus, I like the look of the thicker red cord on here. Might as well say, yeah, might as well make the machine grounded. And I got this really nice rubber plug. Well, I mean, it's rubber, but it's like a hard rubber, especially when this plastic piece is inside there. Flip over again. Ugh. This bag adds about 2 pounds to it. It's insane. And show you guys the Vibra-Groomer too, like, again, I guess. Get the cord out from underneath. Oops. Sorry about that. Didn't mean to do that. Nice and shiny. New brush strips too. Nice and stiff. Come on. Oh, there we go. And these belts last legitly forever in this. Well, at least the genuine Eureka-style RD belts last forever in this. This thing is so beautiful. And there's one rubber end cap. There's the other one. And this Brussel is legitly, like, firmly implanted in the base, too. And I like how it kind of seals the end off right there and how it has the thread guard protection and whatnot. And this thing runs on ball bearings, so it's really smooth. And a sticker that came on it, the Made in USA sticker or whatever, is starting to come off, but oh well, I'm just going to let that rot. Yeah, this is a really nice vacuum cleaner, and these belts never go bad. I mean, they do, but not as quick as people complain they do when they're Sanitaires. Maybe they have the height adjustment adjusted too low, or maybe they should invest in the 8-position dialing app instead of the 6 like I have. Thanks to Caleb Schmall's vacuums, he sent me like a little package full of legitimately like a year supply of Type A bags, a couple Eureka style, that Gert Double style 1 belts, an Oric car back that plugs into your 12-volt cigarette lighter, and the 6-position dialing app. So, yep, I already told you guys about the brand new bag and whatnot, and my phone's timer for the video camera started turning red, indicating me that there's like a minute left. So I guess I better cut this long video short of me just rambling on. So thank you for taking the time to watch, and have a good day. Bye.